demonstration of four keypad matrix and display the number pressed on the LCD screen. So if you click this button, it should display key pressed first button. So you can name the keys. Okay, this is a 4x4 matrix. So four rows are there, four columns are there. So this is the row 0, row 1, row 2, row 3, column 0, column 1, column 2, column 3. So you can name this any keys in calculator and all. You can numbering you already know. No? So you can give number in our program. I am writing here. This is as 1, this has 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, start from 0. Sorry, this is 0. So let us start with 0. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 15. F. Last one is F. Okay. Or if you want to write, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or if you want to write, you can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that is left to you. You can, while loading that lookup table, you have to load differently. So I will show you the program. So where you can load differently. So let us see first the X keypad, how it is connected. This is row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4, column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4. Okay, this is actually the press button will be there. Once you press this button, there is a short between this column to this row. Okay, normally they are open, buttons are open. Only when you press this button, there will be a short here. This is push to contact. Okay, so normally it is open. So like that it will be there. So you have to enable one row and you have to check whether it is equal. One row you have to make zero, ground. Then if you press this button and you have to check column. So that is row scanning, and first you have to do row scanning or column scanning, anyone you can do. So how it is connected, let us see. Column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4 are connected to port number 117. Column 3 is port 116. Column 2 is port 115. Column 1 is port 1. So both rows and columns are connected to same port, port number 1 only. Column starts from 14, then 15, 16, 17. 14, 15, 16, 17. And row number, this is 18 pin, 19 pin, 20th pin and 21 pin. These are row. R1, R2, R3, R4 are rows. C1, C2, C3, C4 are columns. And pin details are here, port numbers. So now next we'll see the program. We have to use LCD and we have to display that value on the LCD. So we have to use LCD files. So these LCD files are provided in the lab. We are having 1 minute. So this is the program. So interface 4x4 keypad and display the key code on LCD screen. So since we are displaying the code on LCD, so we have to include lcd.h and lcd.c file. So this you need not to write. We are going to provide you lcd.c and lcd.h. Both files will be provided in the exam. Only you have to learn this main program. So we have one function here, void column write function. It is unsigned char, is a data we have to put an argument here. So open bracket, close bracket, LPC underscore GPIO1 dash greater than FIO set. We are setting actually 14th pin, 15th pin, 16th pin, 17th pin of GPIO 1, and that is ended with whatever data we're sending, left shoot by 14. Whatever data you are sending here, that data should be left shoot by 14 and do the AND operation with these 4 bits. Okay, you are going to get 14 bit, 15 bit, 16 bit, 17 bit, 1111, because these are OR operation. Okay, and that data is then ANDed with 14th bit. 14th data left shift by 14th. So that is going to write the column. And in the main program, where it is unsigned char I, key and I are declared as char type. Next, unsigned char row value, R value means row value. 4 values are given, initialized with 4 values, 7, B, D, E. The reason is, first we have to make this row value as 0, 1, 1, 1. That means first column is made as 0. Next, second column has made 0. Next, third column has made 0. Here, fourth column has 0. First 0, next second 0, next third 0, next fourth 0. These values you have to give for rows. Okay. Next, keypad matrix is loaded with values 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, these are ASCII values, which you write single quote 0, ASCII value of 0, followed by ASCII value of 1. So, single quote 0, single within a single quote 1. Up to F you have to give. This F you give this sequence 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, DF. You are going to get in the keypad you are going to get this is 0, next 1, next 2, next 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that if you will get. If you want like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The order you have to load as 1, 4, whatever get number now, same order you have to load there. If you load in different ways, you will get different numbers. Okay. 1, 0, next to 4, next 8. This order you can change and you will get different order. So this is the order to get downwards, 0, 1, 2, 3, next column is 4, 5, 6, 7, like that, okay. So init LCD you have to call to initialize the LCD, and this init LCD is actually written in LCD.c. So that's why you are going to include LCD.c. So if you include that file, it is going to initialize the LCD, or running the code written in LCD.c. So next, LPC GPIO1 FIODIR, we are setting in the main program, this is the main program. In the main program, you are setting 14, 15, 16, 17 pin of column 1 as output. Okay. 14, 15, 16, 17 of port 1 has made output port. And we already included LCD.c. If you open that LCD.c, you'll find LCD put string 16 LCD. So there you have to give which row and what value you have to display. So in the 0th row, it will display press X keypad dot dot. So this is a message which will be displayed on LCD. There are two rows. It is 16 cross 2 cross 16. 16 characters you can display. I think I'll show here. So this is the first row. Here we'll get the press any key, and here we'll get the second message. This is the second row. This is the, I think two rows are there. This is first or second. If it is zeroth row, this is first row, or if it is first row, this is second row. Let us see the program. It is zeroth row and first row. In the zeroth row, it will show press any keyboard, and in the first row, key pressed is equal to will come, and after is equal to whatever key will be there now, that key value will be taken from this keypad matrix, value, and that value will be put there. So you can read inside this function what is there in detail in the lcd.c file. It is also given in the manual appendix file, but no need to write that in the exam. We'll provide only this main program later. So in the actual program, while one continuously this key scanning is going to execute, initial value of key is 0. Initial value of the key is 0. For I is equal to 0, I less than 4, I plus plus, because 4 times you have to scan the column or row. So 4 rows, of it is a 4 cross 4, no? So 4 times you have to do increment. So if the I value is less than 4, execute this. So first we are clearing GPIO 1, FIO clear 14, 15, 16, 17. Port number 1, 14, 15, 16, 17 is cleared. Next, column underscore right R value of I. Okay, we are calling column right function with R value of the I value. I value is what? Initial value of I is 0. Initial value of I is 0 means R value of 0. So in the R value of 0, what is there? This is the R value of array. First one is 07. So we are sending, we are writing column value as 0111. So that means in the keypad, we are writing 0111. This is 0111. All are made as these three are made as 111. Only column 1 is connected to 0. So now we have to check we have to check row 1, which row is checked. If in the first row only, if this is pressed, if the key is pressed, then R value you are going to get 0, because this is column 1 is grounded. Okay, 0. We have written column values as 0111. If it is 0, if you press this, this R1 will read this ground value 0. If it is not pressed, still R1 will give the high value. Okay, so that's why you have to check. Suppose second here this key is pressed, so we are going to check R1 is pressed or not. So if it is not giving 0 value, next we'll increment the key value and we'll check R2 is pressed or not. This is pressed or not. So if it is pressed, if you get 0 value, then the key value is 1. Suppose assume that this is also not pressed, then key plus plus will take place and it will check here. If it is matching and it is giving 0, then key value is 0. So like that, if particularly last key is pressed, until here you will not get 0 value. So every time key plus plus will take place. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D. So once the you will get 0 value, then you have to press the current value of key value. So that is the algorithm you are using here. Okay. So now check here. First make R value of I. Initial value of I is 0. So first column is made 0. So now check if not of LPC1768. And we are checking if I open with 21. So 21 is which, you see? R1. This is R1 is, I think, 21. Let us check. R1 is R1, R2, R3, R4. Yeah, R4 is, actually they have taken R4. I reversed the order. So R1, actually 21 should come. 21, 20, 19 and 20 actually, 18. I think for the program written, okay? So you have to assume this as R1, R2, R3 and R4, because we are checking the first row is this one. This R1 should be 21. So assume this is R4, this is R1, R2, R3, R4, like that. So anyway, the concept is you have to check whether the key is pressed or not. If the key is not pressed, you have to increment. Check if not, this is not off, okay? GPIO1 pin value, whatever it is reading, that will be added with value is added with 21 pin. Okay, this is 1 left shifted by 21 means exactly 21 pin is 1, and we are reading the data from the port 1, and FIO pin will give that value. If it is pressed, that will give 0. 0 is added with 1, so it will give 0, and not of 0 is 1. Then immediately you have to break, you have to come out of that, and you have to print the screen whatever value is pressed. If it is not equal to 1, then you have to do key plus plus. So initial value of key is 0. Now it is incremented by 1. Now check the second row, whether the second row it is clicked or not. Again, here also if it is clicked, then 0 added with 1 will give you 0. Okay, if it is not pressed, 1 added with 1 is 1 only, so not a 1 is 0. So only if it is true, it will break. Else, here it is not true. So it will keep plus plus will take place. Again, third row it will check. Again, if you know key is pressed, key plus plus will done, and fourth row is checked. Again, if no key is pressed, key plus plus will come, and again it will you check whether the key value is reached 16 or not. 10, hexadecimal 10 means 16. If key value is 0, reached 16, then you have to show that key pressed is nothing, blank only you have to write. Okay, else if key is not equal to 10, then if it is true, then only you have to do this. Okay, else if it will go to some other, one more time it will increment I plus plus. So next it will write R value as 1, then it will take R value of, this is 0, R value of 0, this is R value of 1. So it will put 1011. That 1011 will make second column as high, sorry, low. This is 1, this is 0, this is 1, this is 1. So second column is made 0, and here also check each column, each row, whether any key is pressed in that first row or second row or third row or fourth row. Okay, again, if no keys are pressed, each time key plus plus will take place. So this will repeat 4 times. Okay, first time I is 0, next time I is equal to 1, next is equal to I is equal to, next is equal to I is equal to 3. So after that I becomes 4, which is this condition will fail. So only 4 columns are there, 4 times different columns are made as 0. If any in any of the combination, if key is pressed, you are going to get true here. Okay, because once the value is 0, 0 added with 1 will give you 0, not of 0 is 1. So if true, it will come out of that, break statement is there. So once it breaks, it will come out of this. At that time of, at the time of breaking, check the key value. If it is equal to 16 or if it is 16, you have to press key pressed is equal to blank. Else go to row number one, 14th character. It is actually 2 cross 16. 2 lines, 16 characters you can print. So you have to go to first row, 14th place, and you have to put LCD put care, and whatever value is there, no key plus plus. That value it will take from the keypad matrix. So keypad matrix loaded with these values, ASCII values of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If key is 10, ASCII value of A is taken and that will be pressed. If the key value is 3, ASCII value of 3 is taken from the keypad matrix and that value will be pressed. That value will be printed. If you want to see what is inside this LCD underscore, go to XY function and you can see the appendix file lcd.c, which is shared at the end of the manual. This is lcd.c. See, we have different functions, void delay, then void column write, LCD column write, void LCD data write. Here, see, LCD go to XY, we are giving two parameters, LCD put char, LCD put string, LCD put string 16. All the files, these things, these files no need to write, okay, we'll provide. Only main program only you have to write. Okay. this will check, scan the key pressed and it will display on LCD screen. I will show which is the, this is 2x16 LCD screen. So two rows are there. This is first one is actually row 0. This is row 1. And display is 0, 1, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, up to 16 character display. So in the row 1, this is row 0, this is row 1, 14 character somewhere here, it will display the key value. Because we are writing the code to display on which position. We are writing a code to display row number 1, not 0, row number 1 means second row, 14 position we are writing. You should not write more than 16 because maximum character is 16 characters. So at the 14th character we are displaying the key value pressed.